Hi, I'm Michael Buchwalder, and today I've brought you to Albans Lakes near St Albans. It's quite a mild December day. I'm going to do some Bloodworm and Joker fishing on the feeder, show you some of the tactics that I use and put it to good use in the World Championships in the summer. It's very similar fishing. It's all about getting the basics right. So let's show you that and hopefully catch a few. I'm going to talk you through the bait now for my day session at Albans Lakes here today. Before I start, I know it's going to happen. Oh, you're using Bloodworm and Joker, it's so expensive. I'm going to try and dismantle a few of them myths today, basically. Talk to you about my Joker first. I've got a match pack of Joker and a hook pack of Bloodworm. So there's maybe 12, 13 pounds worth there. What I don't use of this can then be put back in the freezer with some leer on, which I'll show you. And save for the next time, so that's quite cheap. The only thing that's more expensive, we've got maggots and casters. Obviously, we can freeze the maggots. I won't ever freeze casters. Got some worms, again, if not used, they're back in the bag for next time. Ground bait, I've mixed up probably a kilo of ground bait, so not a lot of ground bait. And some leem here, I've dried out for probably 6 months in a bag that I've burst, so it's really, really fine. That's savable for next time, as is your ground bait. So straight away, we're dispelling the myth that ground bait and Joker and that is expensive. It's not. We've got a few quid's worth here. Most of it can be saved for next time. Ground bait, as per normal, my go-to mix every time I fish in winter is Sonic Baits, Thatcher's Dark, and F1 Dark. Just, I don't really introduce it to you guys. You know it. You've been about the social media all this summer, how good it is for the last couple of seasons. Fantastic. This is not normal, just tear de somme leem, dried out. You see how it doesn't even squeeze together anymore. It's that fine. This I use to separate my Joker out, which I'll show you in a minute. And it adds bulk. Sometimes I'm not catching and I want to try and do something to the peg. I can squeeze it just enough in a feeder, chuck it out the window, hits the surface, great big cloud. Can quite often get a couple of bites. But I'm going to start my session by putting 7 or 8 feeder fulls of this out. There's a couple of ways you can feed it. You can put it in the joke into the leem and separate it out and feed it in your ground bait bit by bit, or the way I prefer to do it today is to try and put a bit of a bed of feed down. So I'm going to fill the like a big window feeder, like basically blobs of it like this, with ground bait on, and I'm going to put 7 or 8 feeder falls out to try and create a bed, because we're at a big lake here. There's some big bream, there's some carp, there's all sorts, big catfish and all sorts of things. There's loads and loads of roach. I want to put a bit of a bed down. It's not often used here, because like I say, none of us in this country use worm and joker anymore. We're almost anti it. If you go to Europe, all the guys that are watching in Europe, you guys fish it week in, week out. You probably count on 2 hands here, the amount of guys that have used it in the last 3 years. So it's a massive, massive difference. So it'd be really something good to get back going in the UK, some bloodworm matches. We're really, really missing them. So hopefully, by people seeing how easy it is to use and what can be caught using it, we might kick it off and see where we go from here. Bloodworm again, we've got a little bit, basically just a perch. Look how good that is, awesome bait that is from Taffy. All we're doing with the bloodworm is we're just going to pick it up as it is there, I've riddled it off, drop it in some water. It's as simple as that now. I haven't got to mess around with it, just basically put my finger in, pick out a bloodworm, hook it 2, 3, 4 bloodworm at a time for this sort of venue, fishing for bigger fish. So bait wise, seems complicated, it really, really isn't. And I'll walk you through it step by step of how we're going to feed it, how we're going to mix up, and how we're going to prepare the Joker for feed. Let's run through how I'm going to start a session today. I've got 2 lines to fish, one at 22 metres, one at 60 metres. So, short line first. I made it really, really simple on that. I've got my ground bait F1 and Thatcher's together. With that, I've mixed a great big handful of Joker and a few casters. And all I've done is I've spent like, give myself a 5 minute slot and I've chucked that little tiny absolute window feeder out as many times as I can, probably 15 times in that. All I'm doing is putting a column of bait through the water with some joker in and some bait in, just trying to make a bit of an area to feed over rather than one big patch to try and catch them on. I think that's the best way of trying to target small fish. I don't think small fish sit over a great big pile of bait, and that's why I've done it that way. Hopefully it'll reap the rewards. The longer line is very different. What I've found the longer line is, I've got an absolute window feeder and a 30 gram here because the water's very shallow out there. I've been absolutely packing that full to the brim with joker with a little bit of lean on, finishing it off with ground bait like I normally would do. And I've had about 9 or 10 chucks out there with that at the start. And every sort of 5 minutes after that, I've had one more chuck, putting some more bait in. I'm trying to create a big bed out there. I'm fishing for big bream, carp, big skimmers and roach. So what I want to do is create a bed where maybe in an hour's time, the fish will come on there, settle down, find the joker, start munching around in it. And by fishing 4 or 5 bloodworm and a couple of maggots on the hook, I'm then creating a pickout bait on the bottom amongst all this joker. So it's a really interesting way of fishing. It's a way I've caught loads of fish on before, and hopefully it's going to work today. Hook choice on a day like today is quite simple for me. I'm always using the pre-tied N30 hooks. They're tied to reflow power, so even if I tied them myself, I'd be using the same gear. I'm going to start off the short line first. I've got 013 to an 18 N30, it's a metre long. I'm going to start using it at the full metre long and see how bites develop, if I'm getting any bites at all, hopefully. And if I start getting loads of indications, I can quickly just bite it off, shorten it down to 50 centimetres and tie it back on. Start getting a few more bites on that line, I'll quickly progress to put a 16 hook on. It takes 2 seconds to change over. The long line, I'm going to start a bit different. I'm using N30, again a 14, so it's a bit of a bigger hook. It's not because I'm trying to do anything different. The way I want to try is put bigger bait on. I'm fishing 4 or 5 bloodworm and a maggot or two, or a maggot and a caster. I'm trying to create something that the fish home in on out there. So hook choice for me is really, really simple. Lakes like this, it's very, very shallow. I'll put my initial feed in with a window feeder, and I'm going to fish most of the day, if I can get away with it, with a hex mesh plastic bullet feeder in 30 gram. The lake's, like I said, it's maybe 7 foot deep out there. It's quite clear. So what I don't want to do is a great big feeder going ba-doosh every time I cast out. So by fishing a small feeder, standing up and putting more force through the rod to compress it and forcing the feeder out, I'm able to get a 30 gram feeder out 60 metres and landing like a bloop rather than a great big cannon going through. I'm squeezing the bait in there quite tight, so the bits on the outside are going to break off as I hit the surface, but I'm pretty confident by the time it hits the bottom in 7 foot of water, most of the bait's still in the feeder. So I'm getting the bait out there nice and tight without creating a massive cannonball effect. We're going to break down the tackle I'm using now for fishing this worm and joker on a feeder. It's pretty much a standard for what any kind of feeder fishing really, you can't change it too much. I've got a Supera 10 foot super light, coupled with an Extremity 520, as you can see, it's had loads of abuse over this summer. Still can't be beaten. 012 absolute braid and about, what's that, 24 inches of a 024 reflow power as a shock leader. That's only so me free running rig and go up and down the line, that's all. Otherwise I'd fish it direct to the feeder. It's just the fact that I don't want the rig tangling up, and I find it better that. Awesome, I've got 3/4 ounce tipping, so if I do get a bite, it's straight round, no messing around. This rod I've set up today, about 22, 23 metres. I've got a clip at 22 and a clip at 23, just so I can quickly follow in and out, and I know exactly where I'm fishing. I think I'll be catching roach on this, some perch and maybe odd skimmers. So I'm gonna be hitting a light hook length on 013 to a 16. Nothing too drastic. Let's try and hook everything we can and try and land everything we can. So fantastic little rod and reel for that short line. The bigger one, I've not really gone overgunned as you'd think. I'm fishing about 60 metres out, but I've gone for a 12 foot 680 gram, a distance master with a 720 intensity. Again, 012 braid, but this time, as I'm fishing for bream and a chance of a big carp in here, I've got 024 reflow power shock leader, but I've got that through the rod, down the rod, and about 5 turns on the reel. What I don't want to do is get a bite, literally could be a carp pull me rod in. I want to hook the fish 015 and a 14's hook, and play them in, and no risk of losing them. It's a great rod, it's really soft, but I can still fish up to sort of 75 metres, even with this like weird crosswind we've got now. It's a really cold day, so I've dropped down the tip size, 2 ounce tip, I'll be able to see every single bite, and sort of 25, 30 foot of shock leaders not really going to make any impression. Absolutely perfect for this kind of fishing today. Well, that didn't take long. We're 35 minutes into the session and we've just hooked the first bream. Believe it or not, four bloodworm and a single maggot, 015 and a 14 hook in the middle of winter has done the damage. So all them preconceived ideas about bloodworm and joker just hooking small fish, hopefully when I land this, I'll prove different. When we've been all over Europe and at fishing world championships, the amount of big fish that the foreign guys catch using it's unbelievable. We've just sort of got it in our mentality that it's for roach and perch and gudgeon and bits and pieces, and we kind of shy away from using it in this kind of fishing. But as you can see now, it's a proper bream. This is like £5, £5, £6 fish on bloodworm. At the end of the day, it's probably the most natural bait that any of us could ever use, isn't it? It comes from water, lives in water. And look at that. Oh, you just got him in the net. Look at that. £5 or £6 a proper gravel pit bream. And I'll quickly show you in a second. He is hooked right in the top lip and the bloodworm is still hanging out of there. What a cracking way to start the session. Look at that, awesome. Winter time fishing like this, I've hooked a great big bream. As I see guys trying to pull their heads off all the time, literally, I'm back on my shock leader now. So this is the most important time, really, the fish under your feet lunging. That's why I've got a shocker on. Just take your time, there's no rush at all now. I've got a 4 or 5 pound bream. Literally, oh. There's no point getting him in from 60 metres and be a hero and lose him at the net. Ugh. What an amazing fish. Just proof that bloodworm and joker really does catch all sizes of fish. That fish there's had like 5 or 6 bloodworm. Let's unhook him and get him in the net. We're now about 2 hours into the session. As I thought, with this cold weather that's been upon us last few weeks, this biting cold wind, it's been really difficult to fish in. But a great start, 30 minutes in, we've had a bream, 5 or 6 pound. But since then, we're 2 and a bit hours in now, and I've managed one more bream. So I've got 2 bream for probably 11 or 12 pounds. So if it was a match, it'd be a fantastic start. A couple of hours in, 2 big bream. Notorious bream for being late feeders, especially on days like this. Probably the best hour is going to be the last hour as the light starts to go. But I'm going to start in a little while, have a look at doing a few little tricks that I know. I've tried the short line, like 15 minute chuck, never an indication at all. And we're fishing virtually braid direct. If there's any fish there, you'd get little perch or something, or roach. I thought we'd get bites straight away. But as winter fishing proves, we haven't really got a clue. So I've gone back long. My next sort of trick after this will be, what I'll do is I'll take off, I'll probably undo the spool, take the clip off, peel off 1, 2, 3. So probably, what's that, 800 mil. So I'm probably like sort of two meters past when the original feed's gone in. I shall fish there for like 10 or 15 minutes. But what I'll do, I shall put a bit more bait in, put a couple of feeder falls in short, then go straight past it. I'm gonna try that. If that don't work, I'll probably have a couple of chucks with a, although a lot of match feed them actually doesn't, it's not allowed. I'll fish a straight lead. I'll have a couple of chucks with a straight lead left and right of the peg and try and entice a bite. But I really think it's just a case of waiting, really. I think the fish are going to be not moving much in this weather. They're really cold. I'm cold. It's just not perfect condition for catching fish, but it's really interesting. You're having to do changes. Notice to be the last bite I had, I pulled it once, left it a minute, pulled it a second time, and then I had the bite. I've tried it again, not caught. So was it luck? Was it just in front of a bream at the time? I don't know. I'm not going to scale down. Both bream have had like 5 or 6 pound fish. There's no point scaling down. A 14 small enough, 0.15. I think anything less than that and you're just asking for trouble. So that's my next port of call. I've not put any chopped worm in yet. I'm a bit dubious yet. I want to sort of give it another hour maybe, give it 3.5 hours, and I'll start putting a bit of chopped worm in. I really think that once I get some bait in and the fish find it, it'll be good. It's just a case of winter time. You've just got to bring the changes and wait, and it's a bit of a patience game. On a day like this, 3 or 4 bream could quite easily win the match. I mean, I know there was a match on here 2 or 3 weeks ago, and one of our top guys, Graham West, was on here, and loads of the guys struggle for bites. So 2 bream in for £11 after a couple of hours would be quite good. But being matchmen that we are, I wanted to be doing this every 2 or 3 minutes. But I have to learn some patience and realise it's not going to be like that. It's middle of December, not middle of June. So I'll give it 5 more minutes. I'm going to put 2 feeder falls in on the same line, then peel off 2 metres and chuck past it. It'll give it maybe a 10-minute chuck. I don't use a stopwatch or anything like that. I just like to fish off instinct as much as anything else. So I just sort of think in my head about what's going on with the bottom and that, and then I'll have a re-chuck. Tend to keep an eye on my phone as opposed to a stopwatch, and I'm not too critical on 10 minutes reeling, 10 minutes reeling. It's not the way I fish. I think it leads you to fish like a robot at times, so it's kind of not for me. I know some of you guys swear by it, but we're all different end of the day, aren't we? I just like to fish bit by instinct and that. So we'll try and quickly get a bite. Literally lifting the rod up, half a turn to pull tight, leaning forward maybe a foot. And when you're trying to entice a bite, it's literally as slow as that. You don't want to start junking it across the bottom. Put it across a bit more. That's probably moved it now about 300 or 400 mil across the bottom. All you're trying to do is maybe spread the bait out behind the feeder, and a bream sees it or a carp sees it and sees a joker and that sat there. Same as summertime though. You should always try to pull for bites in summertime. It's no different. It's all about making decisions at the right time. That's been out there probably, I don't know, 8 or 9 minutes, I suppose. I'll probably give it another few minutes, see what happens. If I don't, then we'll definitely go and try and force the peg a little bit, see what happens. But we're not going to force it too much, being December. So I think it might be a case of unclipping and having a cast around the peg. Because being so shallow, with a lot of fish in the peg, you'd expect to see a few liners and bits and pieces, but I've had nothing. All I've literally had is 2 bites. I've just gone, dunk, 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 and gone straight away. It might be a case of they're not feeding properly today. It's so cold. I mean, we're probably 8 or 9 degrees today. And 2 days ago, it was 0 all week with snow on the ground. So not really good fishing conditions, but that's why it's called fishing and not catching, I suppose. But I can't think of any other tricks to try at the moment. I'm just really sceptical about forcing it. I think the worst thing you can do is, like the old saying, once you put it in, you can't take it out. I just think with bream fishing all year, it's a case of waiting. It's not like skimmers. Like skimmers, you can do things all the time and start a new line here or start a new line there. With bream, you kind of have to make your bed and lie in it and just adjust the covers, as they say, to try and get that extra bite. I'm going to put a couple of feeder falls in now. That's not worked. And let's go unclip and go a bit further. Getting to the last parts of the session now. I'm really cold, hands are in the pockets. it's starting to shake a bit. The fishing's been a lot harder than I expected it to be today. This lake at Albans is absolutely stuffed to the brim with skimmers, roach, carp, bream, like you name it. In the summertime, you can't get a rig in. Today, I had 2 bream early, 1 bream late. I've rocked a few changes up. I've gone long in the end. I've gone probably 10 metres past my feed. First chuck, give it 10 minutes. It's just gone, and that's the only bite I've had along there. So whether they've just backed off the feed or nothing's feeding, I don't really know. It's been a real awkward day. Nothing's ever worked right. You can't line a fish up or anything. It's basically proper wintertime bream fishing where you sat there, and all of a sudden you get a couple in your peg, they tip up. There's a guy fishing further down there. I just spoke to him a little while ago, went for a walk to warm my feet. He's fishing maggots, casters on a method feeder. He's not had an indication all day, so maybe by fishing Bloodworm and Joker, it's caught me a fish. Maybe I'd have blanked without it, I don't know. I've had one fish with one maggot on the hook and 4 Bloodworm, and both on the bream I've caught with 5 or 6 Bloodworm on the hook, so they're definitely eating it. It's a food for thought day though. It's middle of December, it's freezing cold. We've tried everything we can. The tactics are right, I think. So what more can you do? Welcome to winter fishing, I suppose. I'm going to get them out now, show you the fish, show you what we've caught. And they're fantastic looking bream, big fish, £6 a piece. So great fishing wintertime. 3 bream for 16, £18. Awesome. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you picked up a few tips. Tight lines. If you want to see more videos from myself and the Preston Consultants, head over to our YouTube channel, like and subscribe, and the amount of stuff we've got on there is fantastic. There's something for everyone.